welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to pack for long-term travel. But that's complete bullshit because I don't know how to. For real though, I am not going to be teaching you how to pack for long-term travel, as I honestly suck at being a minimalist. And I'm not embarrassed to say it, I really have no idea what I'm doing when I'm packing, so I want to make this clear, this is not a how-to video. If you're here to learn how to pack and be a minimalist, don't watch this video because that's not what this video is about. I'm literally just gonna show you what's in my bag. I'm also going to be telling you some of the brand names, and no, it's not a sponsored video. It's just, I don't know, I find it helpful and I find it unhelpful when I watch packing videos myself and they don't tell me the brand name because I'm like, well, I want that. Okay, so let's start with what's in my suitcase. This is everything I take with me and it's all carry-on. This is my bag, and I just got this, and I'm obsessed with it. Absolutely love it. This is the Away big carry-on bag, so you can actually lock your bag with a code, and nobody can get into it. It's TSA approved, which is sweet. The other cool thing is actually right here. It has, well, this is like an awkward angle. So in here is a portable battery charger, which is really sweet. It's also TSA approved. Everything here is TSA approved for carry-on because that's how I travel. And this is really good because I can charge things all the time and it literally fits into your bag. And you just put it right there. Okay, so basically this is the basic layout. You can unzip this. And here I've got two packing cubes. I've got like purses and water shoes and stuff in here. I'm gonna go into what's actually in these bags. Okay, packing cube number one. So in here I have just like chargers and cords that I like everything organized. So having things like rubber band up and like situated nicely is what I like. I have a lens cleaner. And this bag I have, drone batteries. This is super cool. My mom got me this. No idea where she got it. But basically, you can measure the weight of your bag and know if it's going to be over limits. And this I find really useful. So yeah, there's no brand name. Sorry. Okay, then I have this little cute little speaker. A friend gave me this. It's called Zupar Boy, and it's a travel size speaker, and who wouldn't like that? And here I have my hard drive, which if you can check out my kit account and you can see what kind of hard drive it is. I have a hairbrush, and here I have things again organized. This is all my GoPro gadgets, so we've got batteries, chargers, a thing to charge the GoPro, and yeah. And then I have a coloring book because, well, it's not weird, but I like to color. And, well, that wasn't colored. Okay, I like to have this for when I'm living off the grid and there's no Wi-Fi and like, what else do you do? Next, I have my makeup bag. I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory, but like, this is all my makeup. I guess I have toothpaste in here, face wash, just like random essentials. This is my first big packing cube. Wow, that makes it look like a lot of stuff in here. Okay, we'll start with this. This is my underwear bag. Obviously not gonna show you the insides of this. Then I've got my awesome beanie that I love to wear. Got swimsuits, apparently a bra. I've got socks. I have four pairs of socks. I'm telling you this because I always wonder how many like pairs of socks and underwear people bring. I bring six pairs of underwear, four pairs of socks. And here is just my favorite dress, and I'll be showing you guys my clothes in a second. This is, okay, so here we've got drone cables and chargers. It just, drones take up a lot of space. If you watch my video about like what happens when traveling goes wrong, and I mentioned like keeping other cards and documents in separate things, like I keep my cards in here, and this is my other passport. I don't keep everything in the same wallet because, as I mentioned, if things go wrong, then you're really out of luck. In here, I have goggles because I like to go snorkeling. This is my lavalier mic. Important to have. These are batteries. We're having a trend, just lots of batteries. This is for the G7X batteries. This is my new GoPro I just got. You can check out my kit account and I talk about all my new gear because I'm really excited. But this is the GoPro Hero 7 and it's the best one on the market right now. This is the DJI drone controller. I have another external battery pack and then I have extra propeller guards. Okay, so in that one pouch I had purses, so I have like a good day pack that I take everywhere. This is getting overexposed. We need to turn this down. Okay, so this is my day pack. Then I have water shoes because I really don't like getting my feet cut up when I go snorkeling, so I love these. And they're sharks. This is my travel purse. This is super good because it zips and it buckles, so like it's just thief-proof. And then I have Lactaid because we all have issues. Okay, now we have my clothing bag. We can open it up and show you, I guess, but I'm actually gonna just like do a little dance party and show you what's inside. Okay, so first outfit is the one I'm wearing. This is just yoga pants and yeah, okay. But this is important because this is included. Clearly this would be what I'd be wearing on the plane. And yeah, let me show you the rest. Closer look at my shoes because I think I've got some good style. I got new tennis shoes, by the way, for anybody who noticed, but these are the New Balance pretty rockin' shoes. These are my sandals that I have. I got these in Bali, so I don't think you can get these anywhere if anybody liked them. It's called Cortica. And then I have these shoes. These are, I would always wear these on the plane, like would never pack them because they're too big, but these are Blowfish, and I just think they're really good, like every day, every kind of weather type, like travel shoes. This is my towel. Also a sarong, but yeah, I will use this at hostels so I don't have to pay for a towel, and I'll also take it to the beach and I'll also wear it. Again, this is my tripod case. I'm filming on it, but my tripod fits in here. It's quite big and heavy, and honestly, it's really annoying. And then I have the Selfie Extreme stick. This is something I used to use a lot. I'm using less of because now I have this new camera, but with the G7X, this was super, super useful. It extends pretty far. It's a monopod too, so you can use it for stabilization and then obviously some kick-ass selfie. So this is my backpack that I take, that I have all my camera gear and laptop and just things that I need accessible. First thing, I have a water bottle because a water bottle is essential for travel. This pocket is where I keep my deodorant. Sunglasses, chapstick, just like little things that I need. My retainer, and I think even lactate everywhere. Okay, now I'll show you the inside. This is the first pocket, and here is typically my microphone, but that's actually on the camera itself. So that's what's stored in here. Here I've got extra camera batteries. I like to have Advil because you never know when you need it. I've got pens because you do need this through immigration forms when you're flying. My wallet, passport, just one of my passports. I've got a filter, ND filter. I've got hair clip and then a converter, which this thing is pretty cool. It like breaks down into different converters that you need. I got this at Best Buy for like 25 bucks, so pretty cheap. Okay, so this is the first pocket. Now this is the second. So inside this bag is my laptop. I like to have my laptop within a bag because it's really handy when I go to cafes. I just bring this. So I've got my laptop in here. I have an SSD. I edit my videos off of this. So again, this will be in my kit account. You can check out all the gear if you're interested and also what editing software I use, the laptop, blah, blah, blah. Okay, here is my drone. I have the Mavic Air. It's pretty small, but like seriously, the accessories take up everything. Here I have my Canon G7X, which I'm kind of not really gonna use so much anymore, but I have that. Here is my other lens that I have. This is my zoom lens. The Vario 14 to 140 millimeter. Again, this would be in my kit, but definitely good to have a zoom lens, and it goes pretty far. I mean, it's pretty decent. I actually bid for this on eBay, and I got a really good deal out of it, so that's a hack if you want to save some money. Otherwise, you can go to get it off Amazon. Laptop charger, I have a notebook, and then this is my liquids. So obviously this gains and loses weight all the time, but I've got like everything that I would need. Liquids. In this pocket, I do have stuff, and basically I have my toothbrush separate because it doesn't fit in my bags. So then I have multivitamin gummies, and yeah, yeah. And then these are my drone wind guards, which are really annoying, and I honestly am looking for a solution of something to put them in. That's it. I forgot I have a jacket too. If you can, well here, we'll turn it here. I have a jacket that I do have because, well, I tend to be in cold places and you have to have a jacket.
I mean, to just be real with you guys, it does kind of suck having such limited items and not really having like a fun wardrobe, or at least not that much of a wardrobe. Clearly, most of my bag is full of camera gear and just one packing cube for clothes. So that's why I don't feel like I'm the best packer. I will make sure to put links to certain gear in the video, just maybe some of the gear I like.
I'm gonna quickly show you my old gear because then I'll give you some context of how I used to travel and then how I'm maybe being a potentially smarter traveler. So let's go to that.
Welcome to snowy cold Nebraska. This is my other away bag that I have, and as you can see, it is a lot larger. It is the biggest bag that they carry, so it definitely has to be checked, but it'll be where I'm gonna keep all the rest of my stuff. So this and that other little bag is literally everything I own. So I'm gonna show you quickly inside. Okay, all right, so can you see me? And here is kind of the same layout as the other smaller bag. As you can see, it's really nicely organized. Here you can see that these are my old packing cubes. Now, the thing that sucks about them is they are falling apart. Like, they're ripped here and there's holes everywhere, so they're just not durable. The thing is that you want durable packing cubes because you're trying to stuff as much stuff into them as possible. I bought these back on Taobao when I was in China and I spent really little money on it, and for that reason I got really shitty packing cubes. So I usually am somebody who doesn't like to spend money on anything, but what I have learned is from travel, like, you do need to spend the money on the gear because it wears down. If you have cheap gear, it's gonna break faster and then you're gonna have to keep buying stuff. This is what I used to always travel with. It's an Osprey 50 liter backpacking backpack. So it's literally meant to go on treks because it's got built-in support that hangs around your hips, and this is built for my body. So it is really good, and I'm glad I got it because eventually I did go backpacking, but I didn't do that more than one time. But basically, you can't organize anything. You just throw everything into this bag here in the center, but that means everything on the bottom, you have to pull everything out to get into it. It's just not like practical. I had this for 2.5 years, but honestly, like, I can't stand it and I do not want it anymore, especially because it hurts my back. Like, I'd rather just wheel things around. So I got rid of that. Eventually, my mom gave me this bag. Now, this was actually because I acquired a lot more stuff traveling because I suck at packing and I wanted clothes. So I was actually traveling with this backpack and this suitcase for a while. Granted, I do tend to live in countries, but that's just kind of getting ridiculous. Liz Claiborne, I don't know if you can see the brand. I don't recommend it, so I don't really want you to even know the brand, but it's just like your standard suitcase, and it's just kind of crap. And then, to make things even more worse, I add also another bag that was my personal kind of bag that I use to bring on the plane, addition to my carry-on, and I would also bring this on small trips. I did love this bag. It has a lot of compartments, so you can really fit a lot of things in here, but I ripped it pretty bad here. So I would keep using this, but it's broken. It's by JanSport, so good quality bag.
So now that the video's over, clearly I've got some packing to do. Everything just kind of like exploded. I threw stuff everywhere. Ah! I forgot my Joby! Oh man, this is the worst packing video ever. This also goes in my bag.
Okay, before this video ends, I just got stickers printed with my logo. I got a bunch of them. Here, I'll show you. A ton of Where's Poppy stickers and assortments of colors, and I'm working on sending these right now to my Patreons. If you currently donate $5 or more to my Patreon account, then I'm giving you a bunch of free stickers. I'm actually planning on launching some merch, so if anybody's interested, I'm thinking about making, I don't know, some t-shirts, some tanks, maybe socks with this logo on them, and I wanna know who is interested. I'm also planning on putting these stickers all around the world and kind of creating a game, seeing if you can find them. So it's kind of like Where's Poppy? And if you find a sticker, then take a picture in front of it, tag it on somewhere in social media, and I plan on coming up with a little prize for anybody who finds them and does this.